All right, guys, we'll get back on this bow. Now, I was showing you a little bit there in the intro. What I've chose to do, and I guess it's going to be called like a snaky bow, because it does just have a couple little imperfections, a little crack right here I'm going to try to avoid. It's probably not very deep. And, of course, the knot hole that I'm working with as far as for my arrow rest. Now, I had this marked and keep sweating on it. It's humid here. That's the center, so that's going to be our arrow rest right there. So we could probably kind of draw that in a little bit. Yep, wrong way. It'll be down from this side. I'm just going to make that top of the bow. And these are just kind of a guide. Now, I'm not doing the center line. Not some of the guys do because of some of the imperfections I'm trying to avoid. So what I've done is I went ahead and just took this down to where I had a nice edge all the way across, about a half inch, a little bit better. That way I knew I had a good edge for my bow. And a half inch just rough. It's probably going to be a lot thinner than that. And went ahead and marked my handle in. You can see right there. Okay, and I just came an inch up from the center here, and actually I did a little bit more, almost four there on the bottom half, just because my hands are quite, pretty good size. Okay, and right in here, I'm just going to go ahead and show you right quick. See the way this grain's following here? Now, I just kind of let it just naturally go where it wanted to go, around these knots, all the way down on just this one side here that I've marked. Now, I'm going to come back in, and this is just all going to be rough. I'm probably going to go with a pretty wide bow and just taper it at the tip from about 8 inches back. So, again, I'm just going to kind of follow this grain here on this side. And we're going to go about 1 3/4. Let me get this clamped in here. Okay. Now, from right here, we're going to go about 1 3/4. Now I'm just going to let my finger follow this here. Now the other side is going to dictate its own, so we're going to start out pretty wide, but we really don't want to be any narrower than 1 3/4, so that's just giving us a guideline. Okay, I'll go ahead and get this other side marked out here. Okay, got that marked down there. And again, it's just rough, and generally you would probably go off the center of the bow, but I just started working off the natural grain on the other side. Now, right in here, there's a good chance that that's going to roll out right there, a little bit wide. So we'll just let that do that when we come down through there. Okay, I'm going to get this thing vised down, and we're going to start reducing this other side over here. Okay, we're getting pretty close there. You see where that rolled over that knot right there? Okay, now I've got it reduced down to the line on both sides, pretty close to the lines, and I still yet let it follow. I mean, there'll be some more coming off of both sides, you know, during the sanding. So, right here, I'm going to spin it around. Got my center marked here on the side, just brought it on around the side. And down here on both ends where my arrow shelf's going to go. And let's see. This is where we're going to start our fade. So let's go ahead and get our mark in here. And I'm going to go about a half inch all the way down. And just let my hand follow, you know, the contour of the bow again. Cut the fade in and mark the fade. Okay, and I'm going to duplicate that on the other side and both ends, and we'll come back and reduce the belly out of this thing. Now you can see where we got that marked on this side, and it's marked like that on this side, so we'll have a reference on both sides once we start getting most of this belly out of here. So I'm just going to start right here where this fade's going to go. And I've got to be a little careful right in here. That was that real deep mark, and the grain runs real funny there, and the slab was split really deep.
What is it, Sadie?
Okay. All right, guys. Well, I got some more work done on my bow stave here today. Just showing you how to reduce the wood a little bit. And I've got my handle marked out. I'll probably have to mark it again every time I re-oil it. Each time I work on it, the pencil marks come off. But you can see I've got it. It's going to be kind of snaky, really. Not too bad. I think it's going to turn out pretty good. It's 1 3/4 inches wide. Now, these are all just rough. I mean, I can reduce that more, and I'm definitely going to taper it on the end from about 8 inches down to about an inch or so right there on the tip, both tips. But I've only got that much of it done today. Right there is where my arrow rest is going to be. Right there on that side, and that's where I start the fade. And you can see it's turning out pretty good. So I had time to get on there and work on it today, and storm's fixing to come. Sweet drops of rest. Whew. It's humid out here. So there you go, guys. It's part two, and I'll go ahead and reduce this other side before I get back with you on the next part on the tillering. But I'll go ahead and reduce this part here, and hopefully it won't take me too long to get part three back out there. All right. Thanks, guys.